Hey guys, this is Hannah and this is Bookworms Talk, and today we're going to talk about Rush by Maya Banks. This is a story of the three wealthiest men in the country, Jace, Ash, and Gabe. Ash's little sister Mia, and Gabe has watched Mia grow up. There is a 14-year age difference between the two, but then he realized this one night at the ballroom that she's not so little anymore. And she's always had this crush on him since teenage years, and he's kind of had this thing for her since her 20s, and there's this proposition. Isn't there always a proposition? But no, it's good. And there's logic behind this proposition, you guys. This is not mindless contract. This is not Christian Grey. These reasons make more sense, because he has been burned in the past by his ex-wife, who completely betrayed him along with divorcing him. I mean, that's betrayal enough, but no, drug his name through the mud with the kind of things that their consensual relationship had. So he's guarding himself, not just his name, but his heart. But Mia agrees to this contract as long as her brother Jace doesn't find out, because Jace is her only family. Her parents died, and he and Jace raised her from a young age and takes care of her to this day. He paid her way through college, pays for her apartment, and she wants to branch out and become independent, but she's having a hard time doing that. So to go along with this contract deal that Gabe has with her, he offered her a job as his personal assistant. She thought it's just a cover for their affair, which no one can know about, by the way, because Jace would kill him and their business partners, and that wouldn't end well. But she actually does do a job there. And not once is it really considered for her to be just like a live-in prostitute. That's not what this is at all. In describing this, I realize that's what it sounds like, but it's not. Mia is not so innocent, but when you think about it, Jace and Ash are like her brothers. Gabe was never like that, so let's not get to that weird story. But those are like her brothers. So of course they see her as this innocent little flower that's whatever, but she's not that innocent. She is naive to the world that Gabe lives in, with bondage and such, but it is not the extreme that we have read in the In-Flight series. This is not the extreme that we read with 50 Shades of Grey. It's different. It's a calmer, more realistic idea, and it's a balance between the two. It's not all sex all the time. Yes, there were sex scenes, obviously. That's what this book kind of is, but there was a story with it, and the basic fear is that Jace will find out and see how their relationship goes. It's supposed to be a short-term thing. Is it going to be a long-term thing? There's a series, and I'm going to stop you because I kind of burnt myself a little bit on this. Yes, this is a series. It is the Breathless series, but the first book is focused on Gabe. The second book is focused on either Ash or Jace, and then the third book is focused on whichever one the second one isn't about. This doesn't continue in Gabe and Mia's heads. It doesn't. So I'm just throwing that out there right now so you're prepared. But you get to love these guys so early. I mean, the first chapter, I felt like I completely knew who Ash was, and I felt like I had a pretty firm grasp on who Jace was. But so I want to continue reading the series because I love Ash. This book had seriously some of the best one-liners ever. Not love you, I'd slay dragons and lay them at your feet. I adore you. I, Ash. What's the ever-loving fuck? Anticipation fizzed in her veins until she felt like she was a shaken up bottle of carbonated soda. A come to Jesus moment. For fuck's sake, get off your holier than thou pulpit. Oh my gosh, that one made me laugh so hard. So, I knew I would find lines in this book, and another reason that I loved it, I did laugh. While some things may be serious or uncomfortable, I found places to laugh so many times. I'll talk to you guys later next time on Bookworms Talk when you have read it, I promise. It's worth the read. I got through it so fast and I forced myself to slow down because I was like, but I'm almost done. So, just enjoy it while it lasts. It didn't last long for me. I'll see you later. Bye. So, wow. When Gabe brought her out onto the terrace and ravaged her? Word choice? And at that moment, I quickly deduced that Gabe was a demanding bastard. And he was. Is. Still. I mean, I legitimately gasped at Gabe's comments. I don't know how I didn't see them coming, but I felt like he wouldn't say half the stuff he said to her in the beginning. I was actually like intake of quick air. That's definition of gasp. So Gabe said that in the relationship, she would belong to him body and soul. And I'm like, okay, I got that, belong. All right. A bit intense, but I get it. But then he said that he would own her. That word is so meaning. I don't like that word, to own. To belong? Sure. I don't care if the thesaurus says that that's kind of the same synonym deal. It's not in my head. So we find out early on that Gabe is nice to his mother. Points off the bat, Gabe. So when they were talking about the contract and it said that she had to be faithful to him, and she's like, if the contract says I'm yours, then by God, it's going to say you belong to me. Oh my God, thank you. We have a strong, smart, female lead with kahones. Hallelujah, she doesn't have to address him as sir or master. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. I was getting really sick of the word sir and master. Oh, maybe I've just read too many of those books lately, but damn have I hate those words. And then Gabe said, don't fall in love with me, Mia. And I'm like, I've heard this somewhere before. Where was that? A Walk to Remember. That worked out well. When Jace found out that Mia was working for Gabe, and Jace warned him and basically said, keep your hands off Mia. And Gabe's like, course. But then internally, he's like, I'm going to hell, to burn in hell for eternity. Wow. When we found out about Ash and Jace and their threesomes, I didn't need to know that. Awkward does not begin to describe it. No, no. A new word for awkward is when Jace walked in on them. That, oh, I will get to that. Guys, Gabe held her hair back while she threw up. Seal of approval. You know how I feel about that. What the fuck is wrong with you, Gabe? The thing with Charles? To prove that to yourself, that you didn't have emotional feelings for her? Are you kidding me? So after Paris, Gabe changed a lot. He was tender with her and he didn't demand things of her anymore. He would ask her things. So Charles, blackmailing her. Right after she said that she wouldn't betray Gabe like Lisa did. And she promised him that. You can't betray him. I was a lot of emotions at that moment. I was a pit of anxiety. That's what I was. That whole time, I was convinced that she is going to do what he asks, get the insider information. It all made sense. The things earlier with the girl that broke into his desk. And he's like, I can't not trust the people that work for me. All made sense. And then the thing with Lisa wasn't just there to make us think, yeah, there were other women. No, it was for reasons. And it made so much sense. And it was so misleading. And thank you, Maya Banks, for doing the misleading. Because my heart was... That's what it was doing right there. Maya was like, I don't see any other choice than but to tell Gabe about this and put the situation in our hands. I'm like, hallelujah. I was a ball of anxiety, rocking back and forth anxiety. Oh my God. So Gabe went to Charles and was like, I will find you. There's not one rock on this earth that you can hide under. No one will ever find the body. Gabe, you are awesome. I had a taken moment. I will find you and I will kill you. He sounded like Liam Neeson in my head. When Jace found them, yeah, there still aren't words for that. Just thrashy emotional movements, which I won't demonstrate. And what Jace said to him, really, you know him well enough that he has a guilty soul. And he's saying all this stuff, and it's stuff that Gabe already has thought about. He already feels guilty, and you're doing this, and it's just, stop, Jace, stop it. And he didn't stand up for Mia, which was like, why the fuck, Gabe, why? But then she said, if you ever realize how big of a mistake you're making right now by not saying anything to them, you are going to have to crawl back. And I immediately thought, it's okay, because he's gonna crawl. What was the point of his father and his mother situation other than to really develop Gabe as a character? No, it was for more reason than that, but it was disguised as letting us get to know him. It was so that we know that he would crawl and he would grovel just like he told his father to do. And we knew it would take a lot. When Gabe went to Jace's office and was like, I want Mia to be happy and I want to marry her and all this crazy stuff. And if it weren't for the fact that I knew he hasn't slept in days, I would be appalled. Like, this is not okay, but I was okay with it because that's how they were. And then he said he wants children and he wanted two girls who look just like her. And I'm like, oh my God. Gabe. A billboard. I had a Bruce Almighty moment, like birds in the sky spelling out, call Bruce. That's what I had in my head. But a billboard, come on, give the guy a break. Okay, that ending. There was cheese. I'm not gonna deny the existence of cheese in that chapter. But he was crawling, and crawling involves a certain amount of cheese. I just, my feelings right then, let's do something really elaborate because that's what she deserves and that's what they've been saying this whole time is that she does deserve better and he's trying to be that better person for her. And he proposed her favorite time of the year in the tree at Rockefeller and oh my God. But the thing is, I wanted that confirmation, and if I'm not gonna get a story that continues on in their heads from their perspective, going through their story and not Ash's or Jace's, and they just happen to, you know, sidestep here and there, and so we hear about Gabe and Mia, I'm glad that we had this fast of an ending with all these conclusions that we drew to this, and I was happy with it, because if I didn't have that, and then we got the, oh, he proposed later on in another book, I would have been disappointed. So I'm really happy that she tossed it all in right at the end, and I was so satisfied with it. It made me so happy. Oh my gosh. So let me know what you guys thought of this book. I personally loved it so much. Let me know what you thought that was going to happen when Charles was blackmailing her. Did you think that she was going to do what he said? Like, I don't know what to think. Do you think that Charles is going to be a problem later on, that Jace or Ash or whoever might have to deal with? Do you think that? I don't know what to think. I hope none of that happens, and I feel like it won't, but I, you know, those things never go away completely. I'll see you guys next time on Bookworms Talk, and I will be talking about Truth by Aletha Romig, which I got in the mail, and that's right up there. Yeah. And I'll be talking about that. I'm going to try to pace myself through this guy. It is a lot bigger than Consequences, and I thought Consequences took me a long time, but I will write thorough, extensive notes on that. I'm betting in my new notebook size, I will have 2 full pages. Looking forward to that. So I'll see you guys probably then when I read that, unless I happen to fall upon a short story that I can finish like that. So yeah, I'll see you guys later. Bye! Maya. All of them. All of them. Everybody's kinks in this book.